words you come from.
Is it wrong to be smart?
Hello?
managed to destroy all three keepers. Very impressive. Yes. Please follow me. Keep watch for Durnavir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate.
The sooner we get out of this place, the better.
The Elder Scroll is just a bit further.
Wait. I hear something.
It's Durnavir. He's here. Defend yourselves!
Thank you.
astonishment, but I never thought I'd witness the death of that dragon. Volumes written on Durnavir allege that he can't be slain by normal humans. It appears they were deceived. Unless the soul of a dragon is as resilient as its owner's scaly hide. It's possible that your killing blow has merely displaced Durnavir's physical form while he reconstitutes himself. Hours? Years? I can't even begin to guess. I suggest we don't have allow to find out. Now, let's get you the Elder Scroll, and you can be on your way.
He's leading us to the scroll.
What did you want?
I'm glad you're here. I don't think I could be doing this alone. That's it. That's the last scroll. Come on, let's take it to Dexian.
I have no choice. As I told you before, I'm a daughter of Cold Harbor. If I return to Tamriel, that increases Harkon's likelihood of bringing the Tyranny of the Sun to fruition. As much as it pains me to send you and Serana back alone, I can't take the risk. Remember that Harkon is not to be trusted. No matter what he promises, he'll deceive you in order to get what he wants. And promise me you'll keep my daughter safe. She's the only thing of value I have left. Did you have anything to ask before you? Even if I could, it would only serve to hinder your efforts. Harkon would likely sense my return to Tamriel. The last thing you need right now is a trail for him to follow. Like Serana, I am a daughter of Cold Harbor. A vampire offspring of Yul'Gwan. My presence in Tamriel would simply double the risk that Harkon could complete the prophecy. The only way I'd even consider returning to Tamriel was if Harkon were not only to fail, but to be destroyed. You must understand, he's no longer the man I married all that time ago. He's obsessed. Insane. Everyone around him fears him as they would a rabid dog. For all of this to end, he must die. Remember that Harkon's not to be trusted.
Stay your weapons. I would speak with you, Quinarin. Cursed, not dead. Doomed to exist in this form for eternity. Trapped between Laas and Inok. Between life and death. The hostility was necessary. I was bound to an oath. I believe in civility among seasoned warriors, and I find your ear worthy of my words. My claws have rendered the flesh of innumerable foes, but I have never once been felled on the field of battle. I therefore honor name you Quinarin, or Vanquisher in your tongue. Your words do me great honor. My desire to speak with you was born from the result of our battle, Quinarin. I merely wish to respectfully ask a favor of you. For countless years, I've roamed the Soul Cairn in unintended service to the Ideal Masters. Before this, I roamed the skies above Tamriel. I desire to return there. I fear that my time here has taken its toll upon me. I share a bond with this dreaded place. If I ventured far from the Soul Cairn, my strength would begin to wane until I was no more. I will place my name with you and grant you the right to call my name from Tamriel. Do me this simple honor. And I will fight at your side as your Graze Mazen, your ally, and teach you my food. Trivial in your mind, perhaps. For me, it would mean a great deal. I don't require an answer, Quinarin. Simply speak my name to the heavens when you feel the time is right. There was a time when I called Tamriel my home, but those days have long since passed. The Dovah roamed the skies, vying for their small slices of territory that resulted in immense and ultimately fatal battles. I was, but unlike some of my brethren, I sought solutions outside the norm, in order to maintain my superiority. I began to explore what the Dovah call Elok Dilan, the ancient forbidden art that you call necromancy. The Ideal Masters assured me that my powers would be unmatched. That I could raise legions of the undead. In return, I was to serve them as a keeper until the death of the one who calls herself Valerica. I discovered too late that the Ideal Masters favor deception over honor and had no intention of releasing me from my binding. They had control of my mind, but fortunately they couldn't possess my soul. Free? No. I have been here too long, Quinarin. The Soul Cairn has become a part of what I am. I can never fully call Tamriel my home again, or I would surely perish. I only hope that you will allow me the precious moments of time there through your call. In my language, the Quanaran is the vanquisher, the one who has bested a fellow Dova in battle. You are the Dova King, the Dragonborn. You may not be one of us in body, but you have earned the right to bear this title.
Come back here later, you know, to get those pages. Cause I'm in the mood for some other area than this. But of course I have to teach that.
Some silk. What do you want? I can't believe I'm trading this for some dried up plants. Oh well, a sale's a sale.
The sooner we get the scroll home, the sooner we deal with my father.
On the other hand, I do quickly want to go to the tower, so I will do that one first. Not quite sure which side it is though. think it was that one. There it is. I need
sooner
more.
We get the scroll home, the sooner we deal with my father.
How many of these shard fragments do I need? The problem is I do not want to forget about this one, but I am kind of done in this area for now.
Brought some sure. Got what am I gonna do with it? Sure, here you go. Send a part of it. Maybe it will do you some good.
I'm glad we found this one.